Happy New Year, everybody. This is Julian Lytle, and you have a new episode of Ignorant Bliss here. Start of 2017. This episode is with Jamie Noguchi. He does the webcomic Yellow Peril. He also has a project in which he runs with some other people called Super Art Fight. You might have heard about it. It's kind of like, what if you mixed up WWE Raw and like Pictionary? It's kind of dope. You know what I'm saying? This episode, we talk about his webcomic, Yellow Peril, different stuff he's working on, illustrating. We talk a lot about Tokusatsu. We talk a lot about Power Rangers, Kamen Rider, Super Sentai, like High C era, a little Showa era, a little bit about Kamen Rider Ghost, Jojuzer. I know I just pronounced that wrong, but that's, you know, the current Super Sentai series before the new Star ones released. A little bit of XA ideas of working with those type of ideas. And just regularly, like, just chatting and talking about making art and webcomics and dealing with that type of stuff, too. And Super Art Fight and his travels with that. I hope you enjoy this episode. You can follow him on Twitter at Angry Zen Master. You can also the site is Yellow Peril Comic. Let me see. It's ypcomic.com. Yeah, I'm not editing any of that out. You're going to hear me typing and searching. Check it out. It's a great webcomic. Super Art Fight. Look that up. If you want to, leave a comment. You know where to find this. SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play Music, Blog Talk Radio. It's on there. It's on Stitcher. It's also on Dale on the Taylor Network of Podcasts. I hope you enjoyed this episode. You can, I'm at Julian Lytle on all the social media. Ignorant Bliss Podcast at gmail.com if you want to send an email. Holla at your boy. Talk to y'all later. Peace.
I ain't talking about no bro business. I got money now. All I really understand is since that check came in, everybody talking like I'm really acting funny now. That don't matter. All I hear is since that check came in. I love it when you talk to me. My cash machine. I love it when you talk to me. My cash machine. Since that check came in.
Hey, Jamie, what's going on?
Hey, what's up?
How you doing, man?
Pretty good.
So what you been up to?
Just working a bunch. I've got like a handful of freelance projects that are kicking my ass, and then waiting on comments from a bunch of stuff that I sent out. So it's just kind of like half of it is hurry up and wait, and the other half is get it done.
Like what, you sent out like some pitches and stuff?
No, I sent out some first round illustrations for some stuff. And I'm just waiting on feedback, which is always like, get it to us, like, because we have a meeting tomorrow and it's going to be really urgent. So you know, get it done and then you wait.
Yeah. I suck at freelancing, bro. I suck at that stuff. So I work my regular job.
Yeah, it's better.
It's like, you know, I'm not good at it. The whole portfolio stuff, like, whatever.
Yeah.
But I need to make money because I want a Surface Studio bad.
God damn, that thing is amazing.
And I ain't even been to the Microsoft store yet. I still need to go to the Microsoft store.
Yeah.
So I can, like, actually, like, play with it in, like, real life. But, like, I need that.
It's so good. like Apple's just shit in the bed. Like, oh, look at this fucking touch strip. Thanks. Go away.
That joint made me mad. I was like, if I wouldn't even be mad if like if the Apple joint was that Wednesday and then Microsoft's on Thursday. So Apple was like, we got a touch strip. Like, oh word, that's kind of fresh. Then you get hit with the Microsoft joint. You're taken aback. You fall down. You got to pat your head. You got to wipe your sweat off your brow. You're like, damn. But we was like, we got hit with the Microsoft joint first, and then you see the Apple's like, oh really?
Yeah.
You know y'all had spies. You knew what they was coming with. You know you should have just canceled.
Yeah, it was embarrassing. It was like, come on, man.
The crazy thing is that when I see people talking about like the devices, and they're like, well, it doesn't have like the newest video card, and it only has this, that, and the third. I'm like, yo, like,
shut the fuck up.
It kills me because I'm like, must be making a lot of money off art, because like if you got a decent MacBook or a decent iMac, you're going to drop about, what, $1,300 on it? And then if you want to get a screen that size of drawing, you got to get the 27-inch Cintiq, and that's going to set you back $2,500
without
the touch. If you get the touch, it's $2,800. So it's like, you mean Microsoft say, oh, we're going to give you a whole computer that does everything that does for $3,000? Like, it's winning. Like, I don't even...
Yeah, I don't understand. people who complain about, like, tech specs are just like, you're a different kind of nerd, and also, you won't fucking notice when you're drawing, so shut the fuck up.
I got into, like, a Facebook back and forth, and dude was talking about, it sucks for 3D. I was like, well, that's fine. Like, but there's more to creative people that don't actually do anything in 3D. They're not rendering like Pixar cartoons.
Yeah.
Like if I'm using it, I'm not doing that. Like I'm drawing.
Yeah.
Like, and then there's the people who's like, well, it doesn't have the same levels of pressure. I'm like, you guys, like, here's to let me know that I'm old. I remember when Wacom put out the Intuos, and it was at the same level of pressure as the Surface products, and that was the standard. And people was making amazing art, so it's like,
yeah.
Like, do you really need 2,000 points of pressure? Do you need 8,000 points of pressure?
Yeah, because I had friends working at Udon who were using fucking graphires doing like Street Fighter covers. So yeah. I don't need to hear any of that shit.
Yeah, you can do professional work. Well, yeah, with the old, like, if the freaking driver still worked on the new computer, I would have never bought a new freaking Wacom tablet because the graphire was like, oh, that's I'm good, like.
Yeah.
I first used a Wacom back in like 95. Like, they was.
Yeah.
Like you guys are spoiled. Like, we probably got computers that work like freaking. Like, Star Trek Next Generation. You guys are complaining.
Just complain. And just fucking use it. Because I'm sure once you get your hands on the thing, it's going to be fine.
Yeah. Especially with that little dial thing.
Yeah,
I saw that dial. I was like, yo, I need that in my life right now.
Yeah.
And they're like, the funny thing is I read the tech blogs. It's like, well, Adobe doesn't have full support. I'm like, dumbasses, like the Adobe like keynote is the 2nd of November. Like, you have no idea what they're going to announce.
Right.
Like, they're going to update all the products. So if they update all the products, I bet you it might have full support. And that's like.
And they have a much better relationship with Apple. They have a much better relationship with Microsoft than Apple. Like, I don't know, man. Adobe and Apple are I don't know why they don't get along as they used to.
I think it's because Apple started making products that was, like, trending into, like, their space. When so you're going to buy Final Cut, huh? You're just going to get into the editing movie space. And you know we was promoting Premiere on your computers. Like, oh, so you're just going to get into audio stuff. You're just going to start doing all these things. And that whole flash not on the iPhone probably was like, yo, all right, bet we gonna show Microsoft some serious love now.
Yeah, seriously.
And they put a lot of little intricate little like things in the prefaces about surfaces for like Creative Cloud. That's like, it's crazy. I was like, oh, okay, you mean I can mess with this? Oh, that's what. Yeah, I was like, I see you, Adobe.
God, it's so good.
Yeah, I need it.
I'm just so mad at Apple.
I'm mad. I'm still going to buy a new MacBook Pro.
Yeah, like even though I work mostly on Macs and stuff, and like in our family we've had Apple products since 85, since like, well, even before then, like with the Apple II and the old Lisa. I think my dad was one of the few people who had a Lisa.
Damn, a Lisa.
Yeah, that shit was old. But like, so we're not Apple casual fans, but even us, we're both looking at the announcements last week, and we're just like, come on, Apple, get your head out of your ass. Like, I don't know, man.
It reminds me of that period of Apple before Steve came back.
Yeah, yeah.
And he was like, oh, the Newton? You really think that's gonna be hot? Oh, okay, okay, all right, yeah, all right. Mm-hmm. That's what I see. It's like, it gets me frustrated because some things is dope, and I'm like, I still buy a computer. Like, I just got an iPad Pro just because, like, my homie showed it to me. Like, I was faking on it for a while, and he showed me the stuff he was doing. He let me use that pencil, and I was like, yo, that pencil is the major key right there. Like, that, like, y'all took it to a new level. Like, and I was like, yo, I'm just going to go ahead and cop. I just went ahead, used that next plan on AT&T, that blessing. So I ain't got to drop that huge amount. And I was like, I'm sitting here, I'm drawing on it like every day. And it's like, it's dope, but
yeah,
like, I don't think I could use this. Like, to me, I use like a moleskin sketchbook, but it's just digital.
Mm-hmm.
I know people probably use it for like their main work, and it's like, I don't know if I can, like, I still need Photoshop.
If I can't get full Photoshop on a thing, I don't even bother.
Yeah, like, I still, like, to me it's dope because I still got computers, so I can still be like, alright, I can start this and I can just transfer to Photoshop and just get extra busy. But yeah, it's like, it's dope, it's like, it's really good, but even still, like, Apple, like, you hurt my heart. Like, you just,
yeah.
y'all was killing the game for so long, and then, like, all of a sudden, the last, like, 2-3 years, Microsoft came up and was like, bam, we took all your mojo, we hired new people.
Yeah, yeah. Apple's been like, what, artists use our stuff? Really? We don't see that shit. Let's just make dumb products for people who don't know anything about computers.
Yeah, let's just make phones. More phones.
Yeah, more phones.
Phones and cameras on the phones, because they spend too much time talking about those damn cameras.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't care. But that's what everybody else,
a bajillion gigapixels. I don't give a shit. I'm a photographer.
And I don't, I guess they go, because people use, yeah, people do take too many pictures. It's like, I get blown when people taking pictures. I'm like, yo. Come on, like, why do you have to take a picture of every moment of life right now? Can we just chill? Can we just, it makes me miss the world when it was just like Polaroids. Like, Polaroids came out in special times. Like, you can't just take a picture when you just hanging out watching Netflix now, bang, all the time. Yo, I just walked out the street, picture time, bang.
My people have to know.
It's like, yo, I'm in the Uber, selfie. Like, really? Like, really, you want to take a selfie right now? Like, oh, God. This is where I am.
People are curious. They need to know, Julian. They need to know.
They need to know. That's the truth. So, as we're going through this nice, beautiful tangent into technology and selfies. So, I've been noticing, did you really get back into Yellow Peril, or did you ever actually take a break?
I took a hiatus, I guess. A self-imposed hiatus because, I started freelancing full-time, and so everything I was working on needed to have a paycheck at the end of it, or at least a pathway to make money off of the thing. So there was one week where it was just too much stuff going on, and I couldn't get in a comic plus my regular work, and the comic doesn't make any goddamn money, so... I mean, I fooled myself as long as I could. Like, I deluded myself as long as that delusion could hold out, but as soon as I started freelancing full-time, it became readily apparent that the comic is just not pulling its weight. So that's where the hiatus came in. I was just like, man, I don't know if people will care. Because for a while there, like, I did not miss an update. Like, I was doing it three times a week. And then when Hazel was born, I had to scale back to two times a week. And the audience just wasn't growing. So spending like 8 or 10 hours on the comic a week, when it wasn't bringing in anything in terms of readership, like big numbers in terms of readership that would justify like ad sales and stuff like that, I just couldn't do it. So I was just like, it's a hiatus. And then I had kind of a slow period a couple weeks ago, and so I was like, maybe I could bring back the comic a little bit, but change it so it's less of a ongoing narrative and more like a one-shot kind of Calvin and Hobbes Sunday style strip format. So
I totally know how that feels, man. I do like a new ants like every 6 months.
Yeah.
I just don't feel funny, and then it's just like, yeah, I need to work on some other things that have some more traction, and I need to make money.
Yeah, it's tough, because, like, I love comics, and I clearly would have liked to make money with it, but that's not the main motivation to do it. It was like, you know, I have things to say, I have a story to tell, I have a perspective that I want to share. You know, I want to do a comic with a lot of minorities that aren't doing stereotypical minority things. There's a lot of office humor, but like office humor in the West is basically, you know, a very homogenous workforce, and that's not what we experience every day, like in the cubicles. Yeah. So I wanted to bring some of that. And I think it had a very niche audience, which is why it didn't grow as much as it could have. So like, I like it. I would read this.
Yeah, I don't, but to be quite honest, especially in terms of webcomics, at this point, I don't know what has traction. Like, I think when webcomics first started getting known, you kind of could give, like, you kind of see, like, yo, if you kind of just stick with it, and you promote those certain places, you get an audience.
Yeah.
Then it got to a point where it was just like, I sit down, I was like, I don't know why certain Tumblr things get popular.
Yeah.
I don't know, they just get popular, and like, and to be quite honest, I don't even know when they're popular. I don't even know if they're actually making money or just popular.
Yeah, because those likes and reblogs don't necessarily equate to monetization. Like, I've seen a handful of people do more than just get likes with their stuff. Like Noelle Stevenson, when she was doing Nimona on Tumblr, she was able to parlay that into like an actual book contract. I think Nimona came out from Scholastic, but
yeah.
Like for every Noel, there's like, you know, 50 other people who are getting a lot of attention, but they're just not able to translate that into anything else. So yeah, it's tough. Like, what gets traction, what gets popular, and then what is able to get popularity online and then be sold in a store so that you can actually make a living off of that.
Like, are you able to transition the likes of people like, oh, I love this, but it's free, to, oh, I love this, here's money.
Yeah.
And I know I never figured that shit out.
I'm still not figuring that out.
I don't know. Like, I know sometimes I know my type of humor. People say it's funny. It's like, I guess, like... like, I don't know. Like, I think about it's funny. Like, it's hard. It's like, I don't know. Like, comics is weird. Like, web comics is weird. Small press is weird.
Yeah, small press is tough.
It seems like small press is becoming, like, it's not a bad thing, but it seems like, SPX now is, as long as it's about comics, it's also about, like, the merchandising that the younger artists make around their comic.
Yeah.
So as popular as the comic is, like, the pins are important. The shirts are important.
Yeah, pins blew up this year, man. Pins are all over the place.
I didn't get the memo. Like, like, yo, I went to SPX, and it was like, pins. I'm like, yo, pins is a thing. Like, I've never been about pins. Like, I'm not, like, really? And then I went to New York Comic Con, and it was still like, pins. I'm like, pins. Oh, for real, this is all over the place. And then I went to, like, hipster stores, like, in Soho and shit. I was like,
Oh, Nike got their own pins. Like, yeah. Oh, for real. Like, it's pins is back. I was like that. Wasn't that the thing that the nerds wear on the stuff back in the '80s or something? Like,
yeah. it's swinging back around. Like all the jean jackets with like the hand woven stuff on the back. It's all full of pins now. You got a pin jacket.
I'm like, that's so crazy.
A friend of mine, he's full time freelance, but he got his start. On his, he made a Facebook group, and he was selling pins of his stuff, and that it just his Facebook group went from like a few hundred to like a few thousand people, and now he does like screen prints and pin drops and all sorts of custom art solely through his fucking Facebook. It's amazing.
See, clearly, I haven't figured out my niche yet. I haven't figured it out.
It's, yeah, me neither, man. Me neither.
So, do you have any other ideas and stuff besides Yellow Peril that you're like working off on, like the far reaches of when you have time in between illustration?
Yeah, So I went to the American Library Association conference. I think they have two. They have a summer one and a winter one. And I went down there this summer just because, like, you know, I don't do so well at traditional comic cons or anime shows anymore. Small Press Expo is about the only convention I do really well at. So I was like, well, let me see if I can expand my reader base at least. And a friend of mine did the Library Association stuff a couple years ago, and he was like, oh, this is great. All librarians, they love books. So I had a bunch of books. So I was like, all right, well, let's give this a try. And it was a very eye-opening experience. There was a lot of children books. Although I don't know if there was a lot of children books or if I just notice it more now because I have a kid.
Yeah.
So I have, like, kid radar. Like, I see cutesy things more readily than I used to. So I was checking out a lot of the kid stuff and some of the children books and stuff like that. And I was like, man, I should really fucking do this. Like, there's a built-in audience. I have a test market. You know, I can test it out on Hazel, see if she likes it or if she gets bored. So I went home and I was like, I'm gonna do a children's book. I'm gonna take a month. I'm gonna write it. I'm gonna finish it, and then I'll spend the rest of the time illustrating it. Not that easy as it turns out because I decided to make it all rhyme.
Oh, bruh.
Yeah. Like, I can write a shitty song in like 5 minutes, but when it comes to like having a plot and then rhyming that shit,
oh my god,
I'm still working on it. I'm at the end, so there's a light at the end of the tunnel. But yeah, so that's a big thing that I think I want to try to get at least sometime 2017, and then try to pitch it to actual publishers, because self-publishing is cool. And you can say that you are a self-published author and you can put that indie stamp on you, but like everything else, that doesn't necessarily mean you're making any money.
Yeah.
So I'd like to hand off all the production bullshit to an actual publisher and just concentrate on the work.
Yeah. And they'll be able to market it and things like, I think people don't understand how freeing and how awesome, let's say, the old world was of just like,
oh yeah,
hey, I'm just gonna go to this publisher, drop it off, someone will tell me the stuff is dope, and they say it's dope, they'll give me money, and then they'll promote the hell out of it.
Yeah.
And then, because their main goal is to make more money, and if it's a hit, they're like, oh, we need more of this. And then they try to turn it to other stuff, like this movie came out middle school or something, right? I thought, like, oh, this is just another one of those, like, you know, kid middle school movies. And then I was watching the news one morning and I was like, oh, hold up, the author of middle school, you mean he's a series of books? Like, you mean this dude has been eating, this like 55-60 year old dude is eating, they're telling stories about 13 year olds getting picked on with these little drawings. It's like,
oh my god.
I'm like, yo, that and like the Diary of the Wimpy Kid and Captain Underpants is gonna be a movie. I'm like, this is like low-key like hybrid comics, like kids book thing that no one talks about.
I
mean,
yeah,
millions upon millions upon millions of dollars.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Just because they just know those Scholastic book club probably and all that stuff, and you go into school, it's like, I'm a book. I'm like, damn, yo. I should have thought that shit up when I was young.
Yeah, I was looking around at all the children's books coming out, and I was just like, man, they're getting a lot of traction, and it seems like this is something that I could possibly do, because I can do cutesy shit. So, that was an eye-opening experience. Financially, it wasn't such a great deal, because, like, I made a lot of contacts. But you know how that goes. You get a lot of people talking about your stuff at a show, and then after the show, nothing happens. So
yeah, you email them, and then you don't hear back.
Yeah, it's like, nah.
Yeah. Was it far? Was this conference far?
It wasn't. It was in Orlando, so...
Not too far, but it's kind of far.
Yeah, it's kind of far. The nice thing is they don't have a table fee. So all you have to do is provide an original piece of artwork, and they'll sell it at their charity auction. So in terms of, like, conventions, if ALA is in your town, it makes a lot of sense just to go, because you don't have to pay for table space, and if you don't have to pay for, like, a hotel or a flight, it's in there. And it seems like there's a lot of space for indie creators, because they have this artist alley aisle, and there are a couple of spots open. So it's not like people are clamoring to get in there. But if you have the right kind of thing, I think you can make a go of it. Like, there's a guy a couple tables down who had a whole bunch of fan art and was just selling mad prints of just... mashups and fan stuff, and not a whole lot of his original work, mm-hmm. which is kind of what I was trying to do, is like push my original stuff. Yeah. Because I'm an idiot and I like, oh, I believe in my work, someone's gonna want to buy it. But if you're willing to sell out a little bit and to cater to what's popular, you can make that show into something, because it literally costs you nothing to get in. You do have to get there, and if it's out of town, you have to pay for a hotel and all that kind of bullshit. Yeah. But, like, you know, if I lived anywhere near it, I would go again and again, just because...
Yeah, you just give a piece of art and be like, oh, I'm in,
yeah.
I got art for days. I'm rich in art. Here, take it. Yeah. Here, I got some tables for some friends. Here's some more art. Here you go.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Like,
yeah, it was cool. It was everyone was also super polite and very nice, and they're at least interested in the stuff. Like, even if they didn't buy anything, it was fun to talk to them and to get their perspective on what they're buying for their libraries. A big thing if you're looking to sell your work to libraries or bookstores is to figure out what your property fits in terms of, like, is this young adult, is this adult, is this children's fiction, like the age range, that kind of thing. What is it rated? Those are things that I did not know, so I was probably very useless when I was being asked those questions. I was like, I'm trying, you guys.
I know a lot of people who read, and they read all that stuff, and I review movies, so I learn a lot of that stuff, like, this movie's based on this type of blah, blah, blah book. I'm like, rip, that's a type?
Yeah.
Like, all right, like, when I was growing up, it was just, like, kids' books, old books, grown people books. That's all I remember.
Yeah. The young, what is it, the YA, young adult category, that is huge. Like, if you have something in the YA category, you're printing money. Like, it's just, it's ridiculous.
It's crazy how much of a big market that is. And I think it's also because, like, adults read it. Like, adults read young adult as much as, like, the quote-unquote young adults. Like,
gives
you a demo of, like, 10 to, like, 60 or something, it seems like.
Yeah.
Like, everybody's read Harry Potter. Everybody's read, like, Hunger Games. Everyone reads that. I'm like,
I even read the Hunger Games, and I don't like to read anything without pictures, man.
I don't read fiction. I read, like, nonfiction. I'm on some nerd shit. I'm like, yo.
Oh, wow.
I'm reading shit about economics and shit like that. I'm sitting here getting cynical about the earth. I'm like, we're all screwed. I'm just going to be a bad guy.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I mean, oh, my God. Don't get me started. Fucking, oh, Jesus Christ. The election. Oh, Like, we're in the DC area, so basically, our news is always politics, international news, what's going on, and, like...
We get no bullshit news. Like, this is what, like, when I go to other places, like, when I'm for, like, a con, like, I turn on the news, it's like, oh, you guys have that news they show on, like, movies where it's all, like... You got, like, those puff pieces where you, like, go around and walk with, like, a dog or, like...
Yeah, yeah.
Or, like, the local, like... book sale with the bake sale or something. Like, DC news is like, okay, the actual crime and stuff that happens in the city, then like all politics for like local news is all politics. Like, fuck, like,
yeah,
why do I know about everything all the time?
You can't get away from it. It gets in your blood. Like, it's awful.
It's like, man, why do I know so much? Like, I don't want to know. Like, it makes you so cynical. like, we're screwed, bro. So screwed.
Yeah, like, I voted, but I did not like it.
I'm just going to vote the day of, man. I was like, fuck it. I saw the lines. I saw on TV the lines. I'm like, nah, bro. Like, if I got to go early and I'm waiting in lines, it defeats the purpose of me going early.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just going to go the day of now. They just made it worse. I'm just take some time off from work, walk down the street, vote, walk back to work.
Yeah.
They'd be like, Julian, why you late? Well, I had to get my vote on, so, you know.
I voted, fucker.
You know?
Because America, that's why I'm late. Shut it.
Yeah. I got a government job, too, so they won't say nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. You're like, okay, all right, it's all good.
Thanks. You put it for our boss, okay.
Yeah, man. Yo, man, are you still doing Super Art Fight?
Yeah, actually, we have a show this coming weekend in fucking Canada.
Oh, man, which side?
Let's see. It's London, Ontario.
Is that Western?
I think it's Central because they're... So get this. They're flying us to Detroit, and they're picking us up in a limo and driving us up to Canada from Detroit.
Damn, that's baller.
I know, right? Like, and it's not, I don't think this is a huge Comic-Con. I don't know. It's the Forest City Comic-Con. I don't know how long they've been around, but
limo.
Yeah. Like, they contacted us and were like, all right, you're in Canada. You realize we aren't. And they're like, yeah. Send us a proposal and we'll see what we can do. And we're like, okay. Yeah. Okay, we draw dick jokes poorly, but okay, and they're like, yeah, let's do it. So we're going to be doing our first international art fight this weekend.
Damn, that means you need to make like an international like belt or something. Like,
shit. Oh my god.
Intercontinental belt.
Yeah. You have a real intercontinental title.
like now that you went to another country, you got an official intercontinental belt time now. Like, you moved outside of the borders of the United States of America. You now got two countries. Intercontinental title.
Canada's NWO comes and like steals it from us.
You knock the guys out. Oh my god!
It's a slobber knocker!
Oh my god! Can you believe that? Can you believe what just happened in Canada? Are they part of OVO? Who knows? Blame Drake!
Oh my god, that would be amazing.
That's cool. How many shows do you end up doing with through with Super Art Fight?
It depends on the year. I think one year we were doing a show a month, which was crazy.
Yeah, that's a lot of travel.
Yeah, it's a lot of traveling. We were hitting up a whole bunch of cons. This year it seems like a show every other month. Sometimes there were a couple months where we were doing like shows back to back weekends because we had multiple conventions. But yeah, it just depends on the time of year. Like during con season, it ramps up a little bit because we get invited to a bunch of different local shows. Like we're lucky here because we have Awesome Con, KatsuCon, MagFest. They're all in the same area.
Yeah.
And so we have good relationships with those shows. So we get to do those. And then KineticCon is in the summer. So we always like that show. And then we try to hit up the Auto Bar at least twice a year. And
so wait, what's the Auto Bar?
It's a rock club, indie rock club up in Baltimore.
Okay.
So we try to do that two or three times a year. And then the Black Cat down in D.C., same thing, like two or three times a year. We're trying to expand our borders. So after Canada, in 2 weeks, we're doing a show up in Brooklyn.
Oh snap.
Yeah, it's only our second time up in Brooklyn, so we're pretty excited about that. I can't make that one, but I'll be there in spirit.
You just come in on the screen.
Like yeah, yeah.
Video, live from Talk Your Trash.
Yeah, New York. Motherfuckers are <ours.
laughs> Do they all invite you? Do all the shows invite you like this one in Canada?
The one in Canada did. The one in New York, we did a show up there, I think, last year or 2 years ago with College Humor. And the guy who booked the venue, the booker of the venue, was really happy with what we did and has been trying to find a place for us to do it in Brooklyn for a while, so it's taken us a while to get back there. But that was initially, like, we reached out to College Humor, and they found a venue for us. And so we worked with them on that one. This time around, it's us half being invited up to Brooklyn, half telling them, find us a place and we'll fucking do a show.
Yeah.
So we've done shows in Richmond. And that was us contacting a venue and saying, hey, we do this silly thing. Here's a link. Can we do it at your venue? And they're like, sure. If you can get people in the door. And we're like, okay, we'll do our best. But I think, in general, our experience has been if a venue is willing to talk to you, they'll let you come in. They won't cover anything, so you'll get a piece of the door. So, but generally, venues are pretty open. The venues that we've worked with are pretty understanding of what we do. Certain venues will just say no, outright.
No, like, no, we're not about this.
Yeah, like we're not about indie art. We're not about this kind of thing. So we've been pretty strategic at the type of places that we contact. If there's a burlesque show at a venue, usually they'll be open to having artists on stage do a thing.
Yeah.
If it's a straight rock club, those we tend to shy away from because, you know, if all they do is rock show after rock show, we don't really fit in there.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
You know what I should ask? For the people who probably listen to this who don't know what Super Art Fight is, like,
oh, right.
What is Super Art Fight?
Okay. Yeah. So, we do a show called Super Art Fight. It's a live art competition. We get two artists on stage, and they're drawing on this large canvas. It's about 6 feet high, 12 feet wide. And we have a starting topic. So every match begins with a starting topic. Every 5 minutes, we have a thing called the Wheel of Death, and it's a random topic generator. And so every 5 minutes, the artists get a new topic, and you draw on that. So the object is to sort of attack your opponent's piece. So let's say somebody starts drawing a Death Star, which is a big circle. That's easy to turn into anything, like a Pokeball or like a big boulder or an eyeball or whatever it is. So there's a lot of reversals. on the paper, there's a lot of turning things into other things, like a nose can easily be turned into a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle face, that sort of thing. And at the end of 25 minutes, we choose a winner depending on how loud the audience cheers. So we have a sound meter, a noise meter to measure the applause. And we have two people on stage doing running commentary the entire time. So it's pretty much the closest thing you'll get to Pictionary mixed with pro wrestling. These days, a lot of our artists have costumes and personas. Like they'll come up and dress in a different outfit. I'm lucky because my outfit is just me. So I will come in off the street in a t-shirt and jeans and yell, and that's my quote-unquote persona, because I was there from the beginning, so I don't need to do any of that stuff. Yes. we've done this show for 6 or 7 years now. And we started actually at the Auto Bar and kind of grown from that. Well, technically, we started at Katsucon. They used to do this thing called Iron Artist, which was like Iron Chef, where two artists got a topic to draw for an hour. And they would stay on their side of the paper. And one year, me and my friend Nick, we just screwed up the format. We decided, like, well, let's draw on each other's stuff because things are breaking down and we're already finished. So let's try to extend this a little bit.
Yeah.
And people lost their shit. They were like, oh, my God, we've never seen this before. And so we were like, well, maybe we can take this at the club scene. And Nick regularly worked with the Auto Bar when he was still in town, and so they were gracious enough to let us use their upper space just to see if there would be interest in it, and enough people stuck with it for the entire time. And we've changed the format, so now it's more like a crazy competition, but the very first art fight at the Auto Bar was an hour long.
That's mad long.
Yeah, and there were topic changes every 10 minutes, so that... Yeah, it was long. We had a lot of time to take our time. But we had a steady stream of people watching us. And that was before all the pomp and circumstance, all the costumes, all the showmanship part of the show. So we're like, wow, let's keep going. And over the years, it's kind of evolved into the mess that it is now.
The extravaganza.
Yeah.
That's what's up, man. I remember you when I first met you, and you were explaining this to me. I was like, "So, it's wrestling, but with drawing? Like, I don't even like, huh? Like, I don't know if I'm ready for this. Like, I don't. This sounds interesting, but woo, that sounds wild. I don't know if I could jump into that in that pit. Even though at that time I was full into like my Ric Flair talking stage, and I should have probably just did it because I probably would have been. I probably been the best. I would have kept going, grab a microphone, talking trash like your art sucks.
To beat the man, you gotta draw the man.
You know, I take only the best Ubers, black. I come up in the best Lincoln Town car with the best pens, straight from Japan, the finest Indian inks. How dare you think you can mess with me? Best of all time. See, I'll be all into it.
Who picks in this motherfucker?
Only get Winsor Newton directly from them. I get direct dyes. I don't even buy what you get in the art store. I don't buy on sale.
Yeah, I mean, that's perfect. That's exactly what the show is.
Man. Swag.
Thank you.
So, man, you know, every time we end up talking, about Toku stuff.
Yeah, I thought that's what the show was about. I was like, we're talking about Apple shit? When are we going to get to the Tokusatsu, man?
Yo, man. Yo, I watched the two-parter of Jojuger with my man Captain Marvelous and the Gokaijus.
It's so good.
I was like, yo, they ain't miss a beat. Like, everybody had, like, Joe had his wig on.
Yeah.
Somehow Marvelous had his hair back into the right look.
It was so good.
I was like, yo, how come every time they're in something, they completely take it over? Like, yeah. It becomes, like, another random adventure of the Gokaijus.
Yeah.
It was, animal kids is whatever.
It was their show. I was like, you guys, why did the Animal Sentai even show up? It's the Gokaiju show. Like, get the fuck out, man.
Like, the best part of it was, I'm not going to lie, the super form of the Red Ranger, when he got the whale gun and he got the new outfit, I was like, okay, the outfit is fire.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, that shit is dope. But everything else, I was like, I just want to see more Captain Marvel. It's like, this old fishy dude, he ain't trying to see Captain Marvel's mess. He let himself be cut. You're not even at his level. Like,
yeah.
I was like, oh shit, they got the, I was like, oh damn, they got more keys? When did they get more keys?
And now I'm going to have to go and find those fucking toys.
Oh
my God.
Like the keys for the shows that came out in between.
Yeah. Just get all the useless keys that won't work in the driver. I don't give a fuck. I'm going to come up.
I'm sitting there. I was like, God, like, I was like, oh shit, they got fucking Tokuja keys. Like, damn, the train shit. And that makes me mad, because I was like, do you mean the joint won't say it? Because it'd be dope, like, if you put the key in, if it would say, step back behind the white line. like, that was like my favorite part. That show was so much about safety. Like, hold up. Yo, the train's coming.
It was so good. It made me miss Gokaiger so bad. I was just like, come on. Come on, it's so good. Like, the theme song when da 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 when it kicked in, I was excited. I was shaking in my seat, and no one was home, thank God. But God, so exciting, just so exciting.
And then you see like guy, he talking to like the Tokujirs or whatever, and I was like,
yeah.
Damn, I just kind of want to see them. Like, they just need to have like a two part of every season now, where they just go around, they come back. Guy has to talk to the previous team.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, we need to make keys in your powers so we can have the powers too. Like, I just need this around. Like, I just need him to be like,
we're your senpai.
Yeah, like,
hook us up.
Yeah, like, I kind of would need to, I need like the special where like guy goes to the ninjas and be like, we your senpai, but we're not like your grandpa senpai, because clearly he was ninja around before us, because you also met that old Jiraiya's dude from that old TV show. I was like, but like, we kind of need your keys, and oh yeah, we need your dad's key, even though, you know, he lost his powers and stuff. We need all the keys.
So good. Like, if they show up in every movie as the tie-in to the universe, I'm okay with that.
Yeah, they should just all, they should, one, like, Marvelous, Guy, or all of them need to pop up just all the time.
Yeah.
Just all the time. Like, at least when they have, like, a new Gavin movie with the new Gavin, I'm like, yeah, just bring them along, too. They should just need to be in it.
Yeah. Like, the Gokaijers introduced Gavin.
Yeah, like, they back, like, oh, yeah, that's the homie. Like, oh, Deca Rangers back? Yeah, they gotta fight pirates. So, like, the pirates are there. Like,
yeah. I would be okay with Marvelous showing up in the Kamen Rider universe.
Oh my God.
As well. Like, have you been watching Doctor? I haven't been watching Doctor.
I haven't started yet. It's really weird because I want to know if the level one version, is the actor like a kid, or is it like a little person?
Oh, right.
So weird how it's like Super Mario. It's like, okay, it's a doctor, but then like when he turns a Kamen Rider, it's Super Mario, because he has to start out small. Then he has to get something to grow to regular size.
Yeah, I did see the first episode. So the way it happens is he turns into chibi form.
Yeah.
And then when he, so like the belt creates this game grid in the real world. So it's a little bit like Tron, but not really, but kinda. And he's jumping around and he's bonking bricks with this chibi hammer. And at a certain level, he turns into regular size, but the chibi helmet, the face mask, flips around and becomes his backpack. So the big eyes are still on the backpack. So they've got a regular-sized person in the suit. They just made it chibi-sized, but, like, person-sized. So, like, the whole head is, like, the head and the chest. It's weird. It's very weird.
It's like the designs are so crazy, and it looks like it's another show with, like, a whole bunch of writers again.
Yeah, it was super confusing, the first episode, because at the very end, they introduced all these other dudes with different drivers, and I was like, I'm going to need to marathon this. I'm going to need to wait a couple. I'm going to bank, like, five of them and watch all five and see if it's worth catching up.
Yeah, so. I'm like, that's what I'm trying to wait for. I'm like, I don't know, because, like, Gaim was too good, man. Like, you can't. Like, if you're going to do multiple joints now, like, there's a thing where, like, Gaim was so good that I understand that people was like, yo, Drive is mad weak. But, like, I stuck out with Drive where it got, like, mad deep. Like,
yeah, Drive was cool. Drive pulled it out.
Yeah. So I was like, all right. But then, like, I was watching Ghost, and I was just like, this joint is like some weird, like, slash fiction, like. Are they all in love with the dude with the blue dude? Like, the green dude's in love with them?
Yeah.
And then is the main dude in love with them? Like, and then there's the sister, but no one cares about the female characters, and there's nothing wrong with that, but it's just like,
yeah.
Like, are they in love or not? Like, if you just do it.
Exactly. I was very surprised there was no boys kissing in that entire series. I was very disappointed, and maybe that's because we're looking at it through Western eyes. Yeah. There needed to be some hot boy-on-boy action in that show. Like, they were just so... They implied it so much.
It's so strong. Like, if I had the ability to just buy the license for, like, all of Kamen Rider,
yeah.
When you adapt that show is the gay boy show. That's the gay love interest.
Yeah.
Kamen Rider show. Like, that's it's love, the women, the scientists catching, like, making the women Ghostbusters, and the boys are falling in love and fighting dudes over each other.
We punched each other so hard that we made out.
But it got so slow. I'm like, I don't care about all the jackets now. Even though I thought the jackets were so cool, I'm like,
they were cool, but I was waiting for them to just fuck. I was like, come on,
want to get this over with. Like,
yeah,
who's gonna hold who? Like, I gotta get this over with.
So much sexual tension between those two.
But, like, and then the crazy thing is that also they came out with Amazons, like, dead in the middle of it.
Oh my god! Oh, I loved it. I loved it because it brought back the whole body horror of the original series. Like, I've seen the first couple episodes of the original Kamen Rider, and part of it is Hongo freaking out because they turned him into this robot, like this cyborg. So he can't even do simple things like turn on a faucet. Like, he goes over to a faucet, he tries to turn it on, he breaks it, and it starts spewing water all over the world, and he's just looking at his hand like, what the fuck have I become? And Amazon's totally brought part of that body horror back to the thing. And, oh my god.
Like, it was so, so intense. And I still didn't finish it yet. But it was something about, like, I think I got to, like, episode 7 or 8 or something. Like, I don't know. There's not that many episodes to begin with.
Oh, no.
It's, like, super short.
Yeah.
But it was at a point where it's, like, when the main character joins, like, the crew.
Yeah.
And then there's that one dude that's part of the crew that turns into a monster, and he always gets his ass beat.
Yeah.
And, like, I feel so sorry for him, because it's like, yo, because the show is so dark, it's like, yo, who's, like, he might end up dying by, like, episode whatever. He's not dead at the point where I'm watching, but I'm like, yo, I don't think he makes it out of this.
Yeah, he has a pretty tragic turn as well, so I'm not going to spoil it, but, like, they leave no punch unpunched. Like, they hit you hard in that show. Like, I've rarely had any feelings for Kamen Rider. Like, it's really fun to watch and stuff, but it really gets me to the point where, like, oh, man, the Amazons hits you emotionally.
Yeah. Like, it was, like, what was it, one episode, but, like, one of the dudes in the team gets, like, he gets cut. And he's like, no! And he, like, runs off because he knows he's going to turn into a monster. And I was like, oh, shit, that's so fucked up. And it was just so, I'm like, yo, so this is how y'all taking this Amazon shit? Like,
yeah.
Like, like, I'm thinking now, I was like, yo, so what are y'all gonna do? Y'all gonna, like, remake Sky Rider? Y'all gonna make motherfucking Stronger or some shit? Like, y'all gotta do this with, like, all the OGs now.
God, it would be so great. Like, oh, it'd be so great.
Like, some of those, like, yeah, like, Stronger would be so dope with freaking human Tackle, and, like, oh, it'd be so bad.
Oh, yeah, a dark version of Tackle. I want to see that.
Oh, it'd be so good. Or, like, fucking Super One, because Super One looks fucking incredible. Like,
yeah.
The design of it. I'm just like, because it's funny, because it's like, when I fell deep into the Toku stuff, to, like, because the superhero comics got me. Like,
yeah.
They got me so tired, and it was like, I got deep into this. And I started doing the research. I'm like, yo, like, those original dudes, the original, like, seven, like, everybody up to, like, Black is so gangster.
Yeah, the Heisei.
Yeah, and it's like, it's like, because I was like, they've remade one and two, already before. Like, they bring those back. It's like, all right, we can update, like, one and two and, like, maybe V3.
Yeah.
But it's like, they don't never go past it, so you get to Amazon, you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
They're going, yo, they can do this for, like, all the joints.
God, I need that. I need that in my life. I just need it. Because it was out of left field. But it was great because they didn't draw it out. Like, I feel like some of the writer shows, I love them all. Well, that's not true. Deno can go suck a shit, but like, sometimes I feel like there are a couple episodes that it's like 40 or 50.
Yeah,
sometimes it moves their way, and Amazon's was so tight because it was like, eight episodes or something like that.
It's like 10. It's like something crazy short. It's like, bong, yeah. Bong, 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 bong. It's like, they're just cutting through the story. They're just getting through it. Like, man, like,
yeah.
Fucked up shit happens.
Yeah.
Like, people will turn into these weird monsters. Like, there's the drivers. And they got to eat. You got to eat. You got to eat. Like, I was like, damn. Like, it's,
and what do they eat? They eat people.
Well, yeah. It's like, ah. Like, damn. Yeah, it's like, I wish, like, it's like, since I'm coming into, like, Kamen Rider kind of like the last, like, 4 years or so.
Mm-hmm.
But I mainline so many series. I feel like, I was like, yo, give me this. I'm eat it,
yeah.
Eat it. And I'm just like, all right, like, they got to do. It just seems to me like Gon was so dope that it's been diminishing returns since then. Like,
yeah.
It's like they creatively, they figure it's like, fuck, we made it too good.
It was such a surprise, too. Like, on paper, Gaim sounds like the dumbest fucking show in the universe.
Yeah, I remember, like, before it came out, we talked about it. I'm like, dude, fruit into samurai? It's like, this shit is going on. I don't know about this. And they're like 2 weeks in, it's just like, oh, fuck.
They did it. I don't know, but they did it.
Then you get halfway through it, like, people are dying and shit. It's like, oh, like, nobody's safe.
Yeah. That one show felt like 3 seasons of a show.
Yeah, so much stuff happens. And, like, even, like, the random little one-offs, and, like, they even say, like, yeah, that story didn't count, but whatever. Like, oh, yeah, Kakaider, yeah, he was here, but that shit doesn't count in the story. That
yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, you met the Toku, just, it's imagination. You know that shit don't happen. Like, like, Gon is so dope that when you get to the end, it doesn't even make sense why he's in the team-ups.
Yeah, it doesn't.
Because it's like, yo, he's a god on another planet. Like,
yeah.
Like, there's no reason for him to be back. Like,
yeah.
There's no one who should be able to beat him other than, like, some other superior. Like, the only person that makes sense to meet him is fucking Decade, because that's what he does. Like, I just go around the Earth to meet people. That's my job.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Everyone else, it's like, if you, like, the team up should only be with freaking with Grape. Like, it shouldn't even, like, Gaim shouldn't even come back to Earth. It'd be like, oh, the team up with Gaim is the Grape Kid. He's trying to make up for everything that happened. Like,
yeah.
Like, him and his brother, who was badass.
Like, oh man, yeah, Melon.
Yeah, like, who expected that? I was like, oh man, he's no, like you see him, it's like Melon. He's like, this shit, he's got a white suit. That shit ain't gonna be gangster. Yeah. You see him kick everyone's ass, like, yo, he's hella gangster. Then he upgrades. It's like, yo, he didn't even lose before he upgraded. And then you find out, like, oh shit, he's not even a douchebag. He knows that the world's in danger. It's like, oh damn. And then like he gets fucked up. It's like, oh, this shit is going amazing.
God, yeah, like every an all the shitty cat, like Michi. Michi had a redemption arc. I was like, yo, this guy is so evil and awful and shitty to everyone, and you still love him at the end of the fucking
like
show.
He shouldn't have a redemption arc. He did so much bad shit that he shouldn't even be redeemed. Like,
yeah,
there's nothing to redeem. Like, dude, you tried to kill your brother, B. Like it's funny because, like, the end, you get to, like, the bad guy is not really a bad guy. Like, Baron. This is like,
yeah.
Like, you know, like, yo, like, everything in his life been fucked up. Like, I get why he was like, yo, fuck this shit. I'm just going to become, like, the most powerful, like, other type. And me and Gamma just going to have that final fucking duel to see who the hardest.
Yeah.
And also, like, Gamma had, like, one of the best design final forms I've ever seen. The
yeah, usually. Yeah, 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 yeah. Usually final forms are really awful. Like, final form decayed was terrible.
Yeah. Final form, The best decade is original pink.
Yeah.
Cameron. I call him Kamen Rider Cameron because he was so much pink. Like, he's like pink. He wears the most flamboyant clothes ever.
Yeah. But that stupid thing where there's like a whole fucking deck of cards in his chest, it's just like, come on. Go away.
It's so ugly. And it's funny because then you watching this shit and he's somehow fighting Shadow Moon, which is so fucking amazing. And then they show you like fucking double and you're like, what the fuck is that? This design is so beautiful.
Yeah.
He has a scarf like the old ones.
God, double. Double is another great one.
Dude, he's one of the only ones I like when he comes back. It's just like,
like
if there's only a few that like I would love to like adapt into an American show, and double is like,
double's perfect for
like
it.
It's like in the top three. Like, I think you could do something where you could fold all the everything post decade together into like one story.
Yeah.
And it could make sense along with like some of the early stuff like Kuga and Ajito.
Yeah.
Because especially Kuga and Ajito, they almost feel like the same story at certain points. Like there's the cop and then there's like the random ass enemies that come like kind of stonish and then like. And it's in like, you know, Kuga, he's bad. So I know he's your dude. And then, like, Ajito is weird. Like, I try to watch some of Ajito, and it just wants to.
Yeah, that's a good tough one to get through.
Ones, it's like, what is another Ajito? Like, what? Huh? No, like, just give me the dude in the metal RoboCop suit. Like, that's it. That's the only, that's only what I get.
What they need to do is a cop reunion movie with G3, Axel.
Yeah.
Drive, and put in Joker in there just for shits and giggles because we need Kamen Rider Double and that shit. But like they need to do a cop movie. That'd be so great.
That'd be a great team up.
Yeah,
especially like perfect. Axel with Drive because it's like I turn into a motorcycle. Word, I have a car. Like, not only am I am a car, I have a car, and my car talks.
Yeah, that would be great. That's what I want is like a team up between all the cop Kamen Riders.
I think that would be a great idea. Like, and it's funny. Like there's also like music based ones, right? Because it's like there was the Ryuki, which is the drums and stuff, and his other ones. I feel like it's like music is important, but not the main thing.
Which one was that? They had those stupid taiko drums.
Yeah, the Ryuki is a crazy one with all those. He hits the drums and they. And that one doesn't make much sense to me. I try to get through that. I can only get through 12 episodes.
Yeah, no, I couldn't do that one.
There was a point which I downloaded like everything from Kuga. I was like, all right, I get the first 12 episodes of every show. And then like like fives, I got through like 25. I was like, yeah, I kind of fuck with this mobile, with this cell phone shit. He got a cell phone. He gets this badass outfit. I'm like, yeah, this shit is kind of dope.
That was my first writer show, fives.
It starts off, again, it's like this Amazon shit. Like, it starts off really dark. Like, people dying and shit, and you just don't know, like I don't even know why the main character is a Kamen Rider, but it's everything's so dark. It feels like, yeah, this shit does take place in, like, 2004. Like, everything looks dark and out there. Like,
yeah.
I was like, I fucks with it heavy, though. Like, I was like, this is good. And the shit with the cards. I like the one with the cards. I don't know if I actually like the characters. I just like the way it's just, like, yeah, like, the cars floating around. I was like, oh man, like, yeah, this is a jam. Like, motherfucker, he's clubs or some shit. They just gonna fuck your ass
up.
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, that. And the drivers will sell me on anything. The way the drivers talk, that's what I think. That's what with Saban fucks up with Power Rangers is that he takes all the talking out of the changing devices. Like I'm so mad at I can't even watch Dino Charge because they don't dance.
Oh no!
And the dinosaur gun don't talk. Like,
they don't do the dance.
They don't do the dance.
That's the whole point of the fucking show.
It makes no sense because it's like it's America. Like, with the we love dancing.
Of course.
Like, we dance forever. Like, music is our shit. You're on Nickelodeon. Half the people on the goddamn network got album contracts. Why'd you take the music out? Like, they dance, and it's like. The coolest shit was, like, the old dude was the Purple Ranger, but he does the voices of all the shit. Like, just copy the damn show. Like, there's ones where you shouldn't copy, and then there's ones they copy that they shouldn't copy exactly. Like, they copied the fuck out of Samurai exactly, and it doesn't make sense why, like, a white dude is the lord of a samurai house, and his second in command is like a black dude, and I know I'm supposed to be all about diversity and colorblindness or whatever, but no, like, the shit is from Japan, and it was all Japanese people, and that shit makes sense. But then you have something like Dino Charge, where it's like, people come from all over, the fucking Red Ranger just goes to Brazil, and goes to Carnival, and he's like, oh man, I love dancing in the street for 2-3 days straight, and then, like, all this shit is supposed to be there, like, it has a goddamn, like, Mayan bird god as the mentor. Like, why do you take all this away?
Yeah, it just,
I'm like, Disney would have done that shit. Disney would have kept half that shit. Like, if Disney said Power Rangers, they would have used that. Like, what, you mean we can make more albums? Fuck yeah, we gonna do that. Like, looking back now, I was like, damn, Disney, you should have never sold that shit. You should have thought long term. You would have had Power Rangers and fucking Marvel Comics and Star Wars. You could have put all that shit together and made, like, Star Wars Power Rangers.
Oh my god. That's too much power for one company.
Yo, that would have been... Because you know they would have did it, though, right? Like, they would have done that shit, like, you have the power of the Force, now morph, and they would have fucking changed and be like, oh, shit. And they would have teamed up with Spider-Man and shit. It would have been fucking genius.
Oh my god. Actually, Kamen Rider did team up with Spider-Man.
Yeah, the best Spider-Man, the fucking emissary of fucking hell.
Oh wow!
I'm actually surprised that Marvel or Toei haven't taken this chance to, like, do an anniversary of that show do, like, a one-off to bring that back, because it would make people so much money.
Oh god, that would be glorious.
Like, a new Marveler. And, like, a new emissary in hell, Spider-Man.
Wow.
And then they could have brought in, like, Battle Fever J, because they were supposed to be Marvel characters anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
They could have just merged all that together and do, like, one anniversary movie. Like,
Amazon and V3 and Spider-Man are technically in the same universe.
That doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't, but there's this one episode, I think of Amazon, or... No, it was one of the... Ranger shows where they say Amazon is fighting in the Amazon, V3 is fighting over here, Spider-Man is fighting in America, this is where we have to fight. So it's a shared universe. Spider-Man is in the universe.
Yo, that's it's funny they say Spider-Man is fighting in America and it was like nothing American about that show. like the fact you just say that he's fighting in America in my head is like, no, that Spider-Man is Japanese in Japan. Just like that Japanese Spider-Man manga, which is excellent that no one likes to talk about.
Oh, man.
For some reason, but, like, the fact that you said that Spider-Man's in America, like, what? Nah, man. Like, you can say he's in Okinawa or some shit like that. He ain't no American. Like,
there's one episode where Spider-Man grabs, like, a machine gun and mows down a drug lab. It is so good. So good.
They just need to let that come back for once. Just let them let him come back for like some anniversary things. And they can make some new toys.
My God.
And, you know, it would, you know, it would be so lit. And you, and then, yeah, it, you gotta bring, yeah, you gotta bring like the old Kamen Rider back and be with him.
Yeah.
And yeah, it would be so dope. And you gotta make a new robot. Like, maybe that Spider-Man, like, has to go away like fucking old Goblin had to be, had to get a new Goblin. Like, you can even bring Goblin into it since this Spider-Man's from space anyway. Like, fuck
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, they just need to put, they need to just do that together. Like,
that'd be so good. It'd be perfect because there's a giant robot, so you know, like, Super Sentai would be involved somehow.
Exactly. Because, I mean, they would have to bring in whatever the new team is or whatever, like.
Yeah.
And you can bring in the Gokaiger. See, that's the perfect... Like, this is, like, that's the final key. Like, that's the final key they need. Like, Captain Marvel turns into fucking old Japanese Spider-Man.
Oh, my God. Oh, dude.
And there's, like, a final wave with that shit. There's, like, a web.
He has a Spider-Man key. Oh, my God. Spider-Man!
He does the pose. He's like, oh, like, oh, man. Guy would freak out. Oh,
wow.
Guy would, like, faint. He's like, oh, he's Spider-Man.
Oh, Jesus. This, oh.
That should happen.
Julian, we need to get these licenses.
I need to get rich. Yeah. I need to get the Kamen Rider license.
That's what I would fucking do with $1 million. Like, I would waste it all on trying to acquire these licenses.
Yeah. I'd be, like, over there, like, all right, like, who can we work with? Like, yo, well, Amazon already makes the Japanese one. Maybe we can do something with Amazon over here.
Yeah. I would pull a Robotech. I would buy, like, 3 seasons and smash them into one.
Yo, I already thought about the way I would do it, right? I would, like, the show would start off with fucking, like, with Kamen Rider Skull with the prototype driver, right?
Oh.
Fucking shit up.
Yeah.
Which would then, like, fold into, like, the first season would be, like, Drive, like, I mean, Kamen Rider Skull, like, doing shit, but, like, Kuga, Ajito, and Ryuki were happening at the same time.
Yeah, yeah. And then, Ajito, like, was supposed to be a sequel.
Yeah, I read that. It was supposed to be a sequel to Kuga, right? So, like,
yeah.
I would, like, merge some of that together because, like, when you watch the beginnings, they happen, like, the same... They're so similar. It's just like...
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Like, what's going on? Like,
Kuga is my favorite. He has... His final form has a rider...
Fuck.
Yeah, his final form has a rider kick that can end the world.
See? Again, that's another rider that shouldn't be in team-ups.
Yeah.
Like, once you get to that point, like, you don't win. And so I was like, you know, if you merge those seasons together, and then so you can push them, you do that... And you can mold it right to, like, the whole Fize, like, and all, like, all the other card ones together, like the one with the beetle one with the shiny red one.
I can't think of his name. Kabuto. Right
now. Kabuto and Fize and the card one all together because they all have similar themes with, like, these big corporations.
Yes, 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 yes.
And then you get through that, and then, like, the whole time you could just sprinkle Decade and that dude in the fucking fishing hat. And glasses around. Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you get, like, some really cool, like, old dude acting and be like, yo, I'm hunting you down, Decade. Because, like, he's Decade and he's, like, kind of, like, a good guy, but then you also find out he's, like, fucking the evil. He's supposed to be, like, the grand leader of fucking. Of the big bad guy. Fucking
yeah, Shocker. Like, yeah. God.
You know, all that. And then, like, you can have that point where, like fucking Skull gets fucking deaded. Or some shit. It's like, no. And then, like, you got to lead up to that point. So when you see fucking Double, he's like, yeah, man, he's the shit. Like, to me, it's all leading up to you having, like, Double just being the shit. Just Double just popping out and just like, yeah, I'm that motherfucker. Like, and shit. Like, to me, it's like, like double and O's. Like them motherfuckers had a dope ass story.
Yeah, yeah.
So good.
Oh man, and Ankh. We need Ankh. We need a good Ankh.
You first of all, you need to find like the prettiest dude ever.
Right.
Get like he only has hairstyles that you see in Black Hair magazine, because every time I looked at him, I'm like, yo, he has like the best like perms and rolling sets I've ever seen.
Yeah.
And like a Japanese, he was like Prince, and like he's sitting there, he's hard as core.
Dude, Prince would have been a perfect.
He would have been a perfect Ankh if he didn't pass away, because he's like, of course I'm like the Phoenix, freaking Phoenix, like ancient spirit. Like all that stuff can go together. And, you know, you build up, you lead up to the little X with Forza. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Forza and Drive, and then like, to be quite honest, like after like Gaim, I would probably just like after Gaim, I was like, I'm done. Like you don't need a new no more. Like
yeah, yeah, yeah. It would need to be a limited thing, and it would be like this glorious gem of fiction, and it would live. And be done with it.
Yeah.
Because if you go too long, you fuck it up like they've done with the Power Rangers.
Because it's like, I think I almost think like it was dope in the beginning, up to the point where he was like, I'm done with this, I'm selling it.
Yeah.
So like they ended the storyline, and then Disney took it and they were like, okay, so this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna put some money in this, and we're gonna get everybody union actors, and we're gonna do the seasons kind of like the original shows. But we're going to adapt it correctly so you can kind of get into it. So, like, you know, I know Hurricane Ranger is dope and, like, Ninja Storm is similar, but, like, I thought it was cool because to me I was like, oh, shit, they got another, like, blackish dude. It's like the Red Ranger. Like,
yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Man, this is we on the come up. And it just felt, and they put so much more money into it that, like they used the costumes, but it was like, nah, we can do way better fucking puppets than that.
Yeah.
We bought the Jim Henson company. We could do like the flyest puppets in the world. So like, when you get to like SPD, I'm like, yo, Doggy Kruger in Japan just ain't up to snuff. Like that Disney Doggy Kruger is like the next level.
Yeah, yeah.
They went full Muppet on him. Like that's not like the Japan can't compete with that shit. No wonder they redubbed that shit and showed it over there. Like Disney put that brand in. Like it's now it just seems like they don't like they care, but they don't care.
Yeah.
And then I wanted to give the Power Rangers movie a chance, but the designs are so ugly.
Oh yeah, the Breakfast Club,
Power Rangers. That feels to me like I don't know. Have you ever seen the original pilot of the Power Rangers? How like
no.
All the kids were assholes.
Oh really?
Yeah, like in the original pilot before like the actual first pilot. Like when Zordon's like, I need kids with attitudes. Like they were like a douchebag. Bunch of kids.
Oh no, nobody wants to see that.
But it was funny to watch because it was like they're so different. They're like they're not nice at all. So like, yeah, like I guess they just got their shit together and defeated the Rita and them. But like when yeah. I was watching the new channel, I was like, oh these people just watched that original pilot. Was like, we're gonna make that into a movie.
nobody wanted that, and that's why the pilot never made it out of that.
That's why they remade the pilot.
Yeah, that's why they're like, maybe we should make these kids likable.
My thing is weird. It's just like the costumes look so ugly.
Yeah, they do.
I'm like, they don't like yo. The Japanese designs are dope. Like you can't. You're not gonna be better than that.
Yeah, I thought the original Power Rangers movie that they did way back in the day, I thought that was a nice update to the armor sets, because
yeah.
All it did was give them some interesting panel lining,
yeah.
But the silhouette was the same, the feel was the same, the colors were still nice and bright. You know, it felt like an evolution of the suits, and this thing is, I don't know, Yeah, you're right. There's something about the designs that I just don't like.
The helmets are too, like, spiky and bulky for no reason. I'm like, that's not some shit that made me think, like, yo, I want to get that shit and drive a motorcycle with it on. I legitimately I would drive a motorcycle with the Green Ranger helmet on. Like, yeah, fam. Like, yeah. You're not fucking with me right now. Like, I'll call the Dragonzord out and, like, destroy your city. Like, let's go. It's also weird to me that it seems like, they're expecting this to get more than one movie. So, like, you didn't put the Green Ranger in your first movie? Like, you need to shoot all your load now. Like,
there's speculation that he's coming towards the end.
See, I have this feeling that he's going to be, like, the after's credit sequence, and then,
the stinger. Oh, that would be such a mistake.
And then, like, because so they can play up the second movie where she's a bad guy, but he also, like, it makes a love triangle for, like, Jason, Kimberly, and him.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's like, I remember watching the show back in the day, like, Jason and Kimberly wasn't together. That wasn't a thing. Like, they were just the homies. Like, he's the Red Ranger, she's the Pink Ranger, like, she's the most femme girl out of the bunch. And like, nah, like, Tommy came, like, Tommy's bae. Like, that's, they go together.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, there's no Jason and Kimberly thing. That's like brother and sister's, like, Dick Grayson and Wonder Girl. Like, no, they don't go together there.
Yeah, Tommy came around and Kimberly was like, oh.
That say-ah, that little fucking flying round, that little spinning roundhouse kick in the air. She was like, oh. I'm just like, yo, like, y'all, like, who are they going to fight in the movie? Like,
yeah,
they're going to fight Goldar? They're going to kill Goldar? Because that's the mistake they always make. Like, you're going to kill, like, you ain't going to make the giant pig dude. Like, you ain't going to make some of that funny random shit that you would just see, like, a pig dude with a Roman helmet running around eating stuff. Like, not only is that goofy, but if you think about it, in real life, that would be some of the most terrifying shit you ever see in life. Like an 8-foot-tall, 9-10-foot-tall pig is running around the city with, like, arms and a sword and a Roman helmet and legs. Nobody!
Right.
Just running around, ravaging the grocery stores, eating up all the food.
People would lose their shit. And
you wouldn't want that thing to touch you, because it's like, yo, I don't even know what that is. That's terrifying, and it's goofy as hell.
Yeah.
That ain't gonna be in that movie. Or, like, a dude that's, like, the freaking crab dude is like, oh, man, none of that funny, goofy stuff that's also frightening is also not gonna be in this movie.
Right.
It's gonna be quote-unquote cool, and I'm gonna be like, y'all missing the point.
It doesn't need to be cool. It just needs to, I don't know. We'll see. I'm probably gonna see it.
I know I'm gonna see it.
Because yeah, like, we shit on it, but we're gonna see it.
Like, I'm going to get that free screening, though. I'm going to be in that joint for $3.99. Give it all my critic face. I'm going to give it all my judgment. And I'm going to come around and be like, it stinks. Like the critic, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to be in that joint. Like, oh, man. Like, I can't. Like, I'm going to watch it. Like, because it might have a giant robot in it, Jamie. It might have a giant robot. And really, the last time we had a giant robot was Pacific Rim.
Oh, my God. And Pacific Rim was so good.
Oh, it had more, like, I was always dreaming of, like, the sequel has to be a combiner. It has to be, like, the monsters are bigger, so they have to get a bunch of robots to combine in one bigger robot to save the Earth again.
Tell me more. I like where this is going.
And you can tell that, like, you know, Guillermo del Toro, probably in that sketchbook, was like, the next movie is Voltron. But he has so many ideas, it's like, I'm just gonna go make another movie now. Like, damn it. But I need the movie with the giant robots to become an even bigger robot to fight the bigger monster.
Well, we know, well, we don't know, but we suspect that we're gonna get hybrid kaiju Jaegers in the next one.
What?
Because that was the theory, because Gypsy Danger blew up, right?
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean, like, all of her blew up, right?
True.
That means, so, like, maybe they, and plus the aliens have interfaced with those scientists, so they already have some of that tech knowledge inside them. So, one of the nerd theories was that, like, the next movie is going to feature kaiju Jaeger hybrids, which is super exciting.
So basically, they're angels versus Evangelion. in Evangelion.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Like, that, to me, I think that is actually the perfect way. Like, I don't want to see Americans make a Neon Genesis Evangelion movie because they'll fuck it up.
Right.
We're not at that point where, like, the filmmakers that in America are good enough and but also respect the source material enough to, like, make it. Like, it took so long for, like, Sam Raimi to come in and is like, I love Spider-Man. I painted Spider-Man on my bedroom as a child. So right. I will give the world a Spider-Man movie. And everybody was like, oh my God, that shit is amazing. Or like Richard Donner, we made Superman. It's like, yo, I love Superman. I know Superman. We got Superman the motion picture. It's all good.
Yeah.
Like, we're not at this point yet where, like, the anime fans are like, yo, I love this shit so hard, but I'm also so good at making stuff that I can get to the core. Like, I get it, and I can make it. So, like, if they did something like that, I think that's worse. It was like a Pacific Rim 2. It's like, you use the parts of Ava you like, and you throw your own stuff on it, and you get this. It's like, to me, that's dope. Like, when I watched Chronicle, I was like, this is amazing because it's like Akira, but it's not Akira because y'all fuck Akira up. like y'all don't understand, like, this shit is about, like, rowdy Japanese kids. Like, y'all don't understand, like, no, don't try to make it white kids in New York City. That's not the same.
Yeah, it's not the same shit.
It's not, y'all don't know, like, no. So yeah, Chronicle was, yeah, like, oh, I have some Akira stuff in it, awesome. like I'm happy. That's like as much Akira as I would go.
Yeah, do your own interpretation, but don't, like, do a reimagining of the thing. And yeah, I get what you're saying.
Yeah, it's like they're gonna fuck up Ghost in the Shell, and I have a lot of leeway.
Oh yeah.
But I was like, all you had to do was just not make the character Major Kusanagi. Just call her like Amanda.
Right.
Casey or some shit.
And yeah.
Like, she doesn't need to be Major. Like, you can fit everything and get. In like a near future metropolis here, and it'll work perfectly fine.
Yeah,
just change all the characters' names.
Yeah,
and localize them. It'll be fine. Like, I know people are mad that, like, they're doing Death Note, but they're localizing all the characters. I'm like, no, that's what they're supposed to do because
that's what they're supposed to. I'm not mad at the Death Note one because that one. I feel like they're doing that one right. Also, who did they get? They got
I know Willem Dafoe is doing the demon.
Yeah, Willem Dafoe looks like a hell death demon, so that's proper, man. That I feel like that's stunt casting, man. That's bullshit. They cheated on that one. They did not try. They were like, well, he's already dead. We're just gonna stick him in this.
We're gonna make him fly around the screen.
Yeah.
But it's like, yeah, like that one works. It's like, yeah, just make it some kid in like the middle of like. Of, like, put them in Seattle or some shit or wherever. I don't know where they put them. But, yeah, just make some random sad-ass white kid.
Yeah.
Like, kill people.
London, because London is always dark and sad.
Either way. But I'm just like, yeah, just change all the names. And Death Note works. It's like, it's the same story.
Yeah, like, I don't even need to change the name. His name is L.
Yeah, it's L. So, yeah, that, and I know what's it, the cop he's, like, the cop against him. I don't remember. Like, I couldn't even get into that story. But I'm like, you cop can change the names.
Yeah.
You just change all the names and, like, it'll work. Like, the story is fine. Like, write names in the book, people die. Like, I gotta find out why. Like, let's go. Like, but, like.
Yeah, that one is not, like, a very specifically Japanese kind of story.
Yeah.
It could go anywhere.
Did you ever see, I'm trying to think of the movie name. It was a remake, Spike Lee remade the Korean movie that was.
I did not. Yeah, Old Boy. I didn't see the Spike Lee version. I just saw the original.
It's not bad. Cause like I saw Old Boy, and I really liked it. And the Korean movie, it's a great film. But then I also read the original like Japanese manga, and I was reading it. I read the whole thing. I was like, why did the Korean dude make all these changes? And then, like, so, like, when I got to the Spike Lee version and I was watching, I was like, he took that from the manga? I always wonder why the Korean guy cut that out. Like, damn, like, I missed that stuff. Like, oh, okay. Like, I was sitting there, I was like, okay. Like, and then people was like, this sucks. I'm like, but, like, that was in the original book. Like, that does not.
Interesting.
Even, Like, he put some stuff back in, and he made it a little bit different. Uh-huh. And it's interesting because in the original manga, dude is only locked up for 5 years. But then the Korean movie, he's locked up for like 10 years.
Yeah, yeah.
And then like in Spike's version, he's locked up for 15 years. So it was
split the difference.
Yeah. So in the whole time, like, the original date of the original manga still works. Like, everything goes by the original date of when, like, the original guy gets locked up.
Oh, wow.
So it's like, it's just longer. Like, you could almost say, like, in each story, like, they're all happening. Because it's like, some guy just gets knocked out in, like, 1992. And that shit, and they all happen to, like, different people at the same time. But it's like, people were like, they were like, oh, it's terrible. He kind of just localized the story. Just like, Park localized the Japanese manga for a Korean story. It's like, it's funny how way some people jump on some people for certain things, and they I think they do it the right way.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't give credit for them doing it the right way. So if you jump on people for doing it the right way, and you jump on people for doing it the wrong way, no one's ever going to know which way to do it.
No one's going to make any shit.
Because it's like, you get mad, it's like, only blah, blah, blah should make that. And I'm like, yo, All in the Family was a British TV show, and then like, Norman Lear made that shit in All in the Family. Like, there's so many shows we watch that come from like other countries, and then we localize, we like change it, like classic stuff.
So yeah, the British version of The Office and the American version of The Office are completely different.
Yeah, like they're not even close to being the same thing. Well, like Sesame Street. Like, how many people watch like other countries' versions of Sesame Street? Like,
oh yeah, that shit's bizarre.
Yo, I remember they used to, for some reason, the PBS used to always show the Israeli one a lot when I was growing up. I'm like, do you really want us to know that much about what's popping in Israel that much? Like, you got to show us this version? Like, what's going on? But it's I don't know, man. It's weird. I think about this stuff a lot.
Yeah.
Like, especially right now, it seems like there's always stuff going on with, like, black people in comics. But there's also, like, a lot of stuff going on with, like, Asian people, Asian Americans in comics, and like,
yeah, that fucking Iron Fist, not Iron Fist, is it Iron Fist? Is that the one that's coming out?
That's the TV show, yeah.
Motherfucker. Okay, like, I get. I mean, Iron Fist was always supposed to be like this rich ass white guy. I get it.
I always saw him as Chuck Norris.
Yeah, he was always supposed to be Chuck Norris. It's just really disappointing. But in general, that entire era of Marvel Comics, like, I get why people are mad about the Ancient and let's see, the Mandarin and shit like that. But like, if you think about it, those were stereotypical caricature type portrayals of Asian people. So I'm not mad. Like, I didn't necessarily want to claim the Mandarin as, like, a Chinese villain. Like, I wasn't looking forward to him being cast as, like, I wasn't mad when they did Kingsley, because I was like, this isn't a character that I feel like I should prop up as an example of what we want in terms of representation, because we don't.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't need the Fu Manchu mustache twirling Asian villain. Like, fuck that shit. And the same thing with the Ancient. Like, we don't need the wizened old Asian mystic who knows all the kung fu and stuff. But at the same time, I am kind of disappointed that Iron Fist is sticking to the source material, I guess.
They didn't make any changes. It was weird because when I think about Doctor Strange, it's like, the Doctor Strange movie has all this orientalism or whatever of the past, but they took out all the Asian characters and put in like okay, a black dude is gonna be like the Eurasian dude. We're gonna make the British white lady into the old Asian guy. For some reason, we're still gonna keep Wong the Asian manservant.
We're gonna
put all this shit in. And then I was thinking, like, I retweeted earlier, it's like, it's fucked up, but at least in the past, they kept all the Asian characters Asian.
That's
good
true.
Or bad. Like, at least, like, good and bad, all the Asian people are Asian. And I guess for me, like, I'm coming from a weird place. But I was watching, like, I don't know if you, last Thursday, when I was putting up, like, a whole bunch of Kung Fu movie clips.
I saw that shit. Those things were amazing.
I was like,
Five Deadly Venoms. Jesus Christ. So good.
I'm like, yo, I want the ancient one to be fucking Johnny Wang from fucking old Shaw Brothers movies with the fucking long-ass ponytail and the facial
hair.
That screen presence is like, yo, I could fuck you up in a heartbeat. Like, you have no idea how bad.
Can you imagine if that's the version of Iron Fist that we got? Like, fucking Shaw Brothers movie. Basically, a Marvel Comics version of a Shaw Brothers movie.
I don't understand.
Now I fucking want that. Thanks, Julian.
Yeah, to me, I'm like, what you do is that you take Iron Fist and you take Shang-Chi and you go over there, you go your ass to Hong Kong and you get with whatever remains of Golden Harvest and like whoever's making the dopest shit. So if it's Donnie Yen's production company, if it's Jackie Chan, if it's Sammo Hung, you get them and they produce the show for the Chinese market. And then you just happen to show that shit on American Netflix. But that shit is about Chinese people doing their shit. And that shit would be badass. Like,
that is the hottest fucking thing.
Because that's what should exist. And like, if you want to do fucking Elektra and shit, you don't do that shit. You fuck Elektra. You want to do some hand shit? You just fly your ass over to Japan. You sit down who's making the dopest shit. And you like, yo, we want to make this shit. This shit get this show debut in Japan and America on Netflix same time. But you just make the dopest fucking ninja shit that you can make.
Oh my god!
And we gonna be hands off.
Yeah, I approve of this message. I need that. That would be so amazing. Like if Iron Fist looked like a Shaw Brothers movie, I wouldn't care who the fuck they cast in it.
With the music, it would have been.
Yeah.
But you know, if it was made in, like, Hong Kong, they wouldn't even cast a white dude. A white dude would be, like, a random sidekick that gets kicked in the chest.
Yeah.
Like, you watching Kung Fu movies now, there's always that one, like, oh, this is wondering a white dude. And you know he does, like, something dope, but he gets his ass whooped in, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
By
yeah.
Mile, like.
God.
But, like, do you know how, like.
That would be so amazing, dude.
I don't understand, like. Like, I know it would get watched if they just, like. The Chinese market alone. It's like, yo, what you mean Donnie Yen got a TV show? Iron Fist. Like, he made the fucking Monkey King movie, and it's a 2.5-hour movie. He is in fucking monkey fucking makeup, and I watched that shit like it was, like, the Ten Commandments. So I was like, this movie ain't even that hot, but, like, yo, he's flying around on Flying Nimbus, and he got the fucking pole. Like, this is the best shit ever. Like, I was seeing, like, the Monkey King on motherfucking movie. This shit is fucking fire.
Like, that'd be so great.
Like, why, that shit had Chow Yun-Fat in there as, like, the supreme, like, god of, like, that. Like, why isn't that shit, like, why isn't that shit Iron Fist? Why is it, why is there any white people involved over there? Like,
Chow Yun-Fat should be the agent. That would be
amazing. That's to me. When I first heard Tilda Swinton was, like, cast, I'm like, why the fuck is Chow Yun-Fat not the goddamn agent? I just seen him be the most highest of gods with the Monkey King. So I know he can look like. No, it's supposed to be him. He needs to be trained in Benedict Cumberbatch in the ways of the mystic arts. And he failed.
And
it
will all be subtitled. Don't even bother to have him speak English.
No.
Just like, I understand Chinese. Yeah, it's fucking magic, dude. Get with it.
Like it's, that shit. Yeah, that shit should just all be in Mandarin. Like, I shouldn't hear English until he gets back to New York. Like, what the fuck, like. Like, yo, like, Doctor Strange should be so used to speaking Mandarin that he forgot, like, what it's like to hear English. Like, yo, like, huh.
Oh, my God. Now I'm going to be so sad when, like, Iron Fist, the credits screen shows up, and there's not a Shaw Brothers music in there.
There ain't no Golden Harvest joint. There's no, yeah. There's, like, nothing that you're just like, oh, shit, we about to watch some Kung Fu shit. Like, this is about to go down. Like, I'm, like. And none of this, like, super edit cut shit where it's, like, they cut in between every strike so you don't know why nobody's fighting. You see a fucking Shaw Brothers fight, that shit, the camera's, like, in the center of the fucking field.
Yeah.
It's just like, it's like, damn, did somebody get hurt? Because, you know, that one, like, really, like, it hurt. Like, bap. Like, oh, I'm Iron Fist ain't gonna have that. I'm just.
The camera's on sticks because they don't have any dollies in this.
No. Yeah, they can't move the camera. You don't move the camera. And you got the illest music, like, bah, 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 bah. Like, them ill fucking strings and horns coming,
boom,
like,
boom, 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 boom. fucking timpani for no reason.
Yo. And that shit, yeah, you should, they should even shoot that shit like it's some old shit too, but they not. They not.
Yeah.
They not. Like, this shit don't make no sense.
They aren't even gonna have any Wu-Tang. Because they put that in,
They put it in Luke Cage?
They put it in Luke Cage, so they're not going to do it again. They paid once for the royalties.
Yeah, like, do it again. Wu-Tang should have even been in Luke Cage. This shit should have only been in the Iron Fist show. Like, it should have been just nothing but, like, Wu-Tang music and actual music from, like, old Shaw Brothers movies.
Yeah,
old
Shaolin Shadowboxing and the Wu-Tang short style.
Like, all the sound effects, like, I should, like, yeah. Come on, like, yeah, they're going to be... I know people are going to enjoy it, and they're going to be happy, because I know I didn't watch any of it.
Yeah.
And I would see all the, like, the badass fights people send me from Daredevil, and I'd be like, that shit is alright, but, like, did you see the Raid 2?
Yes. Oh my god. Oh my god. That is some, it's not just amazing, like, hard-hitting choreography, it's really creative. Like, all the blocks that they did, like, grabbing a kick, and then shoving that leg into a wall.
Yes.
I mean, yes. Oh, so good.
It's so beautiful.
you can't go from the Raid to fucking Iron Fist. It just, ugh.
Like, and I was like, I know they got people, like, I don't know. That's why I have a feeling, like, that's why I don't have money. That's why the universe is like, Julian, you can't have power and money. You make your shit would be so dope, people wouldn't even have standards no more. They would just be like, I give up. Like, this shit is too good. I'd be like, yo, this is like, I wish I could get, like, some Warner Brothers money. I wish I could, like, meet somebody and be like, damn, Julian, I like the way you talk about stuff. Why don't you become producer? Here's a bunch of money. I'll be go over and I'll be like, give me Richard Dragon out of DC Comics. Like, why do you want that shit? You'll see. Make some shit on some Shaw Brothers shit. Bah, 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 bah. That shit comes on, like, fucking TNT. People be like, oh, my God.
That's what we just need. We just really need, like a modern Shaw Brothers movie.
Yeah, they do. Somebody needs. There's some, like, good stuff that comes out, because I ain't gonna lie, It Man 3 was fire. I was watching that shit twice.
Yeah, that was good.
But, like, it'd be interesting to see someone make some, like throwback with, like, the music and, like, the edits and the cuts.
Yeah.
Because they still go make, like, the old school stuff, which I'm happy. I'm like, go China, go. Keep making your stories of your history and your myths, because this shit is way more interesting than King Arthur and shit.
Oh, you know? Yeah. Oh, swords, a table, fuck him.
Yo, I know people was like, yo, Julie, you like Asian shit too much. It's like, but bruh, like, their myths are so much more gangster. Like, in Japan, they got ninjas and shit, and samurais, and, like, China got fucking kung fu, and people actually do kung fu. I don't see nobody riding around on horses and swords no more. Like, yeah. I'm like, this shit in fucking Korea, I don't even know about yet. And this shit in, like, Thailand and stuff that I don't know about yet. All this shit is dope. This shit just sound more fire. Like,
yeah.
And I wish it would have been exploited more. Like, I don't know. I just get so, like that's why they need to get, like, more Asian Americans in the comics and everything else. Is, like, so people can just dig into their own, like, cultures from way in front and just put all that shit in stories. I can sit back and be like, oh man, this shit fucking fire. Like, I'm done. I don't need another Sherlock Holmes story in my life. But yo, this motherfucking kung fu shit, is this fucking Pacific pirate shit I don't know about it from Vietnam that maybe happened like 300 years ago. I'm trying to read this shit.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to be sad. Like, anything less than Shaw Brothers level action and choreography and filmmaking. Because you're right, like, the way action is shot in the West, they get the camera all up in your face to make you feel like you're in the action, and you don't feel like you're in the action. You feel like you're watching an ADD commercial because you can't see what the fuck is going on.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like these people never actually watch the fight. Like, when you watch a fight at school, everybody crowds around the fight, and everybody can see the fight. Like, why is the camera so close?
Yeah.
like, come on. Like, this isn't a boxing movie. I think that works for boxing movies, but...
Yeah.
Like, yo, once you start adding in, like, legs, like, nah, you need to back everything up.
And show it the right way. I can't see Johnny get punched in the face if I'm right up in his face.
Like, I don't want it. Like, I'm like, y'all messing up. That just shows that your choreography is whack. Like...
Right.
The Matrix got it right. It was like, the Wachowskis was like, you know where we going? We going to Hong Kong. We going to get the best dude in the game. And then you still watch the Matrix, it's like, yeah, you can see everything that happens in those fights.
Yeah, because they're still like, great. They're still great.
Because it's like, yo, we making a Kung Fu movie. Like, that's what you're supposed to do.
We making a Shaw Brothers movie in the Matrix.
Yo, man. I still kind of, it's interesting that they've never made a superhero movie. I know they probably want to make their own projects, but I'm like, the fact that Warner Brothers didn't get them to make, like, the Justice League or Superman or something is just dumbfounding to me.
Yeah.
Because it's just, you could just tell, like, yo, they would make a badass Superman movie.
Well, I mean, Speed Racer was kind of a superhero movie.
Oh, I love Speed Racer to death because when I watched it, I was like, I'm watching a cartoon with real people. I don't know how they did this, but they made 70s anime with real live people.
It was fun. I resisted for the longest time, but I watched it and I was like, why were people hating this? It's not that bad.
Because they don't know Speed Racer. I think that's the main people. They were like, this is sucks. Like, that means you've never watched Speed Racer because when you see freaking Dan from Roseanne lift a guy up in the air and throw him around like the cartoon and hurl him, I was like, what the? And like when like Matthew Fox is talking like, I was like, oh my god, he really is Racer X. Like,
yeah.
Like, oh my god. Because, like, I saw this in the theaters. I saw it in IMAX 3D.
Oh my god.
You have no idea. The colors, Jamie. The colors.
The colors. How can you see normal things now?
Like, I'm sitting back, like, oh my god. And, like, there's no depth of field in that movie. Like, literally, they were like, yo, there was no depth of field in the old anime, so we're going to make it so there's no depth of field. Everything's in focus. And you're sitting there, and it's like the real IMAX, like the one in, like, Dulles in the air.
Oh, yeah, the Uberhausi? Holy shit, dude.
So it's, like, super huge, and, like, everything's in focus, and cars are, like, running around. It's like, this is low-key a classic. Like, he was like, this movie's stupid. I was like, you guys have no idea what you just saw. Like, this movie's amazing. Like, that might be still my favorite Emil Hirsch movie. Like, that and, like, the movie about Milk. Like, when he's in Milk. Like, that's it. Like, Emil Hirsch is only, like, the two movies. It's like Speed Racer and Milk. Like, that's it.
Wow, Speed Racer, man.
Low-key, one of the best. We're going to think about it in, like, 15 years. People are going to be like, damn. That was a really good movie. When they talk about, like, movies who got it, like, got anime right,
yeah.
Watch, they're probably like, we hated on it back then, but looking back, this movie is low-key amazing. Maybe by that time we'll get a good Dragon Ball movie by then.
Ugh, I don't know about that.
It's possible. I have hope in the future. Maybe that person doesn't exist yet. The person that can make the Dragon Ball movie. That person might be a baby. Maybe it's Hazel, Jamie. Maybe.
Oh my god. Hazel, we're going to sit down and we're going to study now. This is Goku.
Start with little kid Goku, though. Start with little kid Goku.
Right.
We can't lose the humor. We can't lose the humor. Him peeing for no reason. Or like, him turning into a giant ape and everybody freaking out. By the way, watching Super? Have you watched Super?
No.
It's hilarious.
Is it?
Because they have a character, the Beerus character. He's like Morris Day in the Time. And like his angel, that like his servant is like Jerome.
Oh my god.
And like he destroys planets and stuff, but like all they want to do is eat really good food and hang out. So they come to Earth and Bulma gives them like food and like they don't destroy anything. Like they train Goku and shit, but he's like, "Yo, Bulma, like I'm here. Where's the new food?" And he's like, "She's like, well, what's up with these shrimps though?" And they're like, "Oh, what is shrimp?" And they start eating. They're like, "Oh my god!" And then like Goku fights some big powerful dude, but then who cares? I'm just waiting. I was like, "Oh my god, they just ate pudding."
I get excited. I feel like this is a show after my own heart. Like, I just want to eat good food.
That's all they want to do. And then, like, there's fighting because it's Dragon Ball. But,
right.
Like, literally, like, there's a lot of them eating. And then, like, he's a brother. And then he's like, "Yo, in my reality, I got Earth and they got the best food." And he's like, "What do you mean they got the best food?" He tastes a little bit. He's like, "Oh, my God." And they have, like, a tournament. So who gets the Earth? Not for, like, to destroy it. Not for, like, treasure. Just to go eat.
I gotta get me my father.
like, there's so many things. Like, where's the... Like, I want to see the comic. Like, I want to send messages to Toriyama. Like, "Yo, just have them go to Five Guys." Like, like have them eating a cheeseburger and, like, fall out from, like, like me heavenly. Because everything right now is, like, Japanese food. It's like, I know, that tastes great. But, like, have them go to, like, other countries. Because Mama's rich. Like, go to Italy, eat spaghetti. So they can be like, "Oh, my God, spaghetti."
Oh, spaghetti with meatballs. Oh, Jesus.
Like, I want to see that. But, yeah, my bad. I interrupted you, but, like, that show has the same Dragon Ball Z stuff where they fight. But it has the humor from the first part of the show when, like, Goku was a kid. Like, it has that stuff back.
That's really great.
And, like, there's half the time I'm laughing, like, there's an episode where they have to fight, like, this evil god guy, and, like, Goku and Vegeta are just arguing, like petty arguing, like, "Yo, why did you forget the urn?" Like, "I don't know, I got excited because I was going to fight." Like, Kakarot, like, this is the thing you're supposed to do. And, like, and the bad guy was talking, and the other bad guy was like, "Yo, you know they're not listening to you." He's like, "Yeah, well, I just want to talk just to hear my own self talk. Like, I don't care." I'm like, this is in the cartoon. This would never have been an old Dragon Ball Z. This is amazing.
Yeah. I was just like, fuck it. We're going to do this.
Like, I'm just going to have fun. Like, here. I'm going to get more money. I'm going to have fun.
They keep making me do this goddamn show. I'm going to do it this way.
Yeah, it's so fun, dude. It's so much fun.
I'm really surprised that we haven't seen a Cowboy Bebop movie yet. Like, of all the anime that should be localized or turned into an American movie, I feel like Cowboy Bebop is made for that.
I agree, because to me, I don't even consider most of the characters Japanese.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know what they are. They're just people in space.
Yeah. Like, of all the property, and I know it's been rumored for a while, but, like, I don't know. I don't know why it hasn't been done yet. Like, that should have been the first one out the gate, not, like, Dragon Ball Evolution or whatever the fuck that was.
Yeah, instead of, like, all these movies that shouldn't have been, like, yeah, like, Cowboy Bebop, or even, like, some old shit like Dominion Tank Police, like...
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Tank Police. Or fucking Trigun.
Yeah. Like, crazy shit. Love and Peace. Love and Peace. there's so many, like, it's like, there's, like, old stuff like Demon City, Shinjuku, or Wicked City, where, like, you really don't have to be Japanese. Is just, like, supernatural horror in a city. Like, yeah, I think, well, Demon City Shinjuku, you have that Boken, so I don't know, like, that might need to be more Japanese. But, like, Wicked City was just, like, a cop, and, like, monsters was in it. Just, like, you could just make that as a movie now, and it'd be fire.
Or, like, Vampire Hunter D. That should be...
I don't understand why Vampire Hunter D isn't... I don't understand why Castlevania isn't, like...
Yeah.
Movie franchise. It's like,
yeah,
Simon Belmont should be like, I should have been seeing a Simon Belmont movie.
Yeah, I mean, you would have thought so by now. Like, some of these, Akira is a pain in the ass to do. Ghost in the Shell is going to be a pain in the ass to do. These things are easy as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, Castlevania would be easy. Ghost, Trigun would be easy. It's essentially a Western with space guns.
Yeah.
It's like, it's Firefly. You know, like, all of these would be, because we've done them before.
Yeah. Like, it just, Like, well, watch, somebody's going to listen to this, and then they're going to be like, these guys are right. Someone get blah, blah, blah on the phone about the rights. Because, yeah, like, some of this, like, that prime era anime, like, that, like, like 85 to, like, 98, like, almost, like, not all that stuff has to be, like Project AK really doesn't have to be Japanese either. It's, like...
Yeah, just a whole bunch of ladies.
It's, like, girls in a boarding school. Like, they just need to have school uniforms on.
Yeah.
Like, they don't have to be, like, the Japanese school. They can be Catholic school uniforms. Like, one girl needs to have superpowers.
Yeah.
The other, like, mean girl needs to have, like, an armor suit and just hate the other girl. And there's, like, the little blonde girl that they both want to be friends with.
Yeah. And the technology, we have the technology to do a Cowboy Bebop really well.
Yes.
We have the technology to do a Trigun really well. And, like, you wouldn't have the problems of, like, whitewashing that everyone has a problem with, like, Akira or Ghost in the Shell.
Because, yeah. like, with Vash the Stampede, like, I don't know. Like, I never cared about what he was. It was just, but, like, I like... Or, like, what was the dude with the big, like, cross on his back that had all the guns?
Yeah.
For me, he always felt like George Clooney. I'm like, wait, I don't think it'd be George Clooney now, because George Clooney's old. He's not doing nothing like that. But you can get some cool white dude actor be walking around with a big cross on his back, and then, like...
It'd be perfect. Like, no one would give a fuck.
No, it'd be like, yo, Trigon's got a movie. Like, that's where everybody would be like, oh, my God.
Yeah, people would be like, this is amazing.
Like, Toonami's finally got to the, like, we got movies coming out. Like, yeah, like, you made a perfect point. Like, Bebop, I still don't, like, that movie, that show is perfect. And it's, like, it's split up. There's, like, 22 episodes. You could do 3, maybe 4 movies.
Yeah. They made a movie for us. Like, it wasn't that popular in Japan, but Japan made a movie for the Western market.
That shit was lit. I like that movie. I fucks with that movie.
It was amazing. It was great.
Like, they can literally just make, like, they can cut, like, the first, like, couple of episodes into a movie, the next set into another movie, remake the animated movie, and then, like, do the last couple of episodes with, like, Vicious and everything, and the wrap-up.
Oh, Vicious Cycle would be amazing.
Yo, Vicious was such a crazy... That was all, like... Everything with his ex-girlfriend and Vicious and the...
Yeah.
His life before, I'm like...
Yeah. I mean, this is a ready-made property. It's got a huge fan base. People would lose their fucking minds.
And the soundtrack could be incredible because you can just get... I always thought, like, if you do an American version, you get American jazz artists to play the music from the show.
Yeah, Yoko Kano would compose new shit and get, like, an American jazz band to hook that shit up.
Like, Brian from Marsalis or whatever.
Yes.
Like, you go to, like, you know, New Orleans, get all them jazz artists, people just, they, like, they just playing, like, just play Tank. And, like,
people would lose their shit. An hour and a half of just Tank. And, like, some stupid models off a runway posing, and people would buy tickets to that movie. Oh, I would buy tickets to see that movie.
You know, like, Bebop would be so fire.
Like, that's what I don't understand. That one is easy to do. You don't have to change anything. It's not.
You don't even have to change the name. His name is Spike Spiegel. Like, Spike. Like,
yeah.
Jet.
He's got Faye. A German last name.
Yeah, like Faye. Faye Valentine. Like the dog is named Einstein. You even have a dog in it, goddamn it. Like,
yeah.
Dog in it.
Yeah. Like, dog lovers will love it. Bebop lovers will love it. Sci-fi lovers will love it.
Cool music, cool outfits.
Come on.
Then it just happened to be a spaceship. I mean, when you watch the first episode, you see this in a spaceship, you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, a spaceship? This is in space?
come on, man. I mean, it'd be so good. It'd be so tight. They make so much money.
It doesn't have to be expensive. They'll figure it out one day. They'll figure it out. We'll be old, but they'll figure it out.
Yeah.
Figure out.
Yeah, leave Akira alone. Leave Ghost in the Shell alone. Make a Bebop movie. If you make a Bebop movie, then you can try Ghost in the Shell and Akira. But until you make me a Bebop movie, fuck your shit.
I don't think they should ever try to touch Akira. That shit is wrong. Like, just don't fuck with it. Like, you don't want it. Like,
yeah, I agree. But they're gonna do it.
The only thing I want to see about Akira is that in 2020, if I can get my weight up and I can get some tickets to Japan, I can go to the Olympics. And they do some crazy honoring of Akira during, like, the opening ceremonies or some shit.
Oh, my God.
That's it. That's the only thing I want to see about Akira. For, like, anything with, like, Western people involved. It was like, oh shit, like fucking Doraemon, Akira, and fucking Super Mario. Side note, I don't know, did you see like the closing ceremonies for Brazil?
Yeah, yeah, that was crazy.
And Super Mario grabbed the thing and went down the pipe, and the Prime Minister of Japan came out with the hat on. I like, I got chills. I'm like, yo, Mario, the Olympics, this is next level. Like, I feel about this. Like, Mario? Japan got to do it to the next thing.
Oh my god, so good.
I was so excited. I was like, yo, I need all, like, I need so many video game and anime characters in the next Olympics. Like, I need just not one mascot, all the mascots. Like, Pikachu for this. And like Cowboy Bebop was for the club, and like go to the Cowboy Bebop like after party, like oh, this is everything, like Street Fighter is like the logo for fucking karate or some shit, like it's Ryu, like
yeah
I want all that. Yeah, all right, man, we've talked for 2 hours.
Holy shit, that's amazing.
Yeah, man, I enjoyed this episode.
That's because the last hour is all about Tokusatsu.
Yeah. People going to learn some more about it, because we really love that. I love that.
Hell yeah.
I love that stuff to death. But yeah, man, it was great having you on. I enjoyed talking to you. Really talk about, like, all your stuff.
Hell yeah, man. Anytime.
Thanks for being on. I guess I'll see you online pretty soon. I don't know what the next convention I'm doing. You're about to go to Canada and do it up real big in a limo. You should drink up all their champagne.
This one's mine.
You say, pour it, taking it to the Super R fight with you. Like, this is how big time I am right now. Like, you got the best show in all of art and comics.
Oh my god, that'd be great.
Yeah, man. All right, man, I'm gonna let you go now.
I did.
Thanks again.
Later.
Peace.
The first is that God is better than the world's best thing. God is better than the best thing that the world has to offer.
Magnify, magnify, lift it on high. Spit a Spotify to qualify a spot on his side. I cannot modify, ratify. My mama made me apple pies, lullabies, and alibis. The book don't end with Malachi. Devil will win employee of the month by the dozen. Till one scoring 3 years from the third when he doesn't. My village raised him a child, come through the crib and it's bussing. You meet anyone from my city, they gon' say that we cousins. Shabak, Barak, edify. Electrify the enemy like Hedwig till he petrified. Any petty Peter Petter group could get the pesticide. 79th. I don't believe in science, I believe in signs. Don't believe in signing, I seen dollar signs. Color white, collar crime. Good God, the gift of freedom. Hosanna Santa invoked and woke up slaves from Southampton to Chatham Manor. My dream girls behind me feel like I'm James Early. The type of worship make Jesus come back a day early. With the faith of a pumpkin seed, size mustard seed here. For I will speak noble things as entrusted me. Only righteous, I might just shrug at the skullduggery. I couldn't stand to see another rapper lose custody. Exalt, exalt, glorify. Descend upon the earth with swords and fortify the borders where your shortest lies. I used to hide from God, duck down in the slums like shh.